The voice of Sherry.
Good morning, and this is Arlene. We have here, as I said, Professor Dr. Angel Kocsimek. He is a professor of tourism, a visiting professor in Help University. So welcome to Durian ASEAN.
Yes, good morning. Thank you for inviting me and to be with you. Durian is important word.
I wonder if you have tried durian before or not.
I know that somebody tried to produce durian without smell, but durian without this smell is not a real durian.
That's true, that's true. Yeah, and durian is, I think, it's an identity for Southeast Asian and also Malaysian in that sense. Yeah, it's a cultural identity or fruit identity, I would say. So I just want to give a brief introduction of who you are to our listeners. So Dr. Kocsimek, I don't know whether I pronounced the name well.
Angel Kocsimek.
Angel Kocsimek. Yeah, so you're from Croatia, right?
From Croatia. Yeah. You know where is Croatia?
Yeah, it's in the Baltic, right?
My God, no, Croatia is in the heart of Mediterranean area, South Europe. It is one country, the most beautiful country in the world, with 1,200 islands.
We have to go there.
Very good soccer players and sport. It is beautiful country. Mm-hmm. And you have to compete to be, to me, second nicest country in the world, if my homeland Croatia is number one. But Malaysia indeed is a beautiful country.
Yeah. Apologies for my ignorance about Croatia, but I do
but
know.
But you have to know, I'm so disappointed, my dear. You have to know Croatia. But from now, you will study more.
Yeah, but at least I know Croatia once won number 3 in the World Cup. But
yes,
in a
few
years ago.
It was in France during the World Championship. We are so proud. We have very, very successful sport there.
Yeah,
Pete,
so
I
do
like
know
me,
a
like
bit of Croatia.
Yeah, it is just very, very tall and strong athletic people there.
So you held broad experiences in numerous fields, namely economics, tourism, international marketing, political studies, and diplomacy. Political marketing, information and media, environmental studies.
Foreign affairs, an ambassador to different countries. Mm. Regarding ASEAN, I was special representative from Croatian government to ASEAN based in Jakarta. And I spent almost 20 years in beautiful Asia.
Wow. So just to give a brief description of the numerous senior position that you held is United Federation of Travel Agents Associations and serve as Croatia ambassador, like you see just now, Minister
Plenipotentiary.
That is
with
not
all easy. Power, it means.
Plenipotential and special representative to ASEAN. You are also a lecturer and visiting professor at universities and institutions in the U.S., Croatia, Japan, and...
It means I'm a very old man.
It means that you are well-traveled. Yeah, you also went to Korea, Vietnam, Malaysia, and Indonesia.
Yes, I visited about 100 countries in our world. Satu Dunia is for me, indeed, our world.
And you published 3 books. The books that you publish is Tourism Business, 100 Questions, 100 Answers, Tourism Policy and Management in the Asia-Pacific and Cross-Border Cooperation in Europe with Emphasis on Croatia.
Yes, very interesting topics.
Very interesting, especially the 100 question and 100 answers.
Do you have one question? Please go, don't go.
Yeah, I have several questions today that I want to ask you. First off...
It means new edition of my book should be, it will be larger.
I think so, more than just 100. So first of all, why you come to Malaysia? What was what attracted you to come to Malaysia and teach?
It's a very, very good question. When I completed my diplomatic career after working 41 years, it was time to go to my country to enjoy with my chuchus. I have grandson and granddaughter, beautiful wife. My son is painter, just tall like Mr. Yap, very, very active man and now well-known painter in Croatia. And I decided to go there, but Help University president, that took Dr. Paul Chan, my old friend, invited me to come here just short time to be visiting professor. because 15 years ago I was just guest speaker for one executive talk about Asian financial crisis, and Help University invited me for 1 year, and I came here and fall in love to Malaysia. But after my plan was to be here 1 year, but unfortunately after less than 1 year I was attacked by gangsters, because it is maybe problem after we can talk about tourism and security issues. I maybe for gangsters, robbers, I look like maybe one rich Orang Putih, and they attack me only because of my laptop in my bag, and they cut bell or and also almost my hand.
Ah.
It is not TV to see, and I was practically killed.
Ah.
And many people after that surviving and just going out of the country. And my government and my friends tried to transport me to Croatia, but I decided I will stay here. And I discover how beautiful people is here. In trouble, you can discover more than a regular, and particularly in diplomatic life, everyone is nice around you, to you. But real life, you can recognize when you are in situation just to lose your life.
I see.
And it is reason that I extend. I perform 5 surgeries every year. One, and after that, last year I went finally to be retired to Croatia, but Help University decided to invite me every year to be here, shortly 1 month visiting professor, and they appointed me to be member of International Help International University. Council, something one very, very high top
International
body.
University Council.
Yes, mm-hmm. Very, very interesting. And I'm so honored. And now, just after this session, pleasant session with you, we are going to have a lecture to one group of Chinese students. Very, very interesting profile of individual student and completely student population. Can you imagine? We have students from, I think, more than 60 countries, and about 10 or plus thousand of students, and it is a great challenge. Mm-hmm. I came here to establish School of Tourism and Hospitality Management. It was successful project. I'm so proud mm-hmm. of this project, because it was very special mission, not only to educate people in Malaysia, young generation, how tourism is important, but also to introduce maybe or to open new horizon to public, to society, how tourism and hospitality together is new moving revolution.
To begin with, what is tourism? Like, I think majority of people would see tourism as a way for people to move from one country to another country and visit.
It must be beyond that, right?
Sorry.
Tourism is industry of free or leisure time. Mm-hmm. It means everything what is related with our free choice. After tidur, sleeping, after to work, bekerja, if I remember it is
to
from
work.
Indonesia, to work, and you have additional third part of your daily life, what you have to do. It is time of leisure, and everything is under tourism umbrella. To go to travel agency, to go to hotel, restaurant, to go for entertainment, to go everywhere, what is your free choice? Recreation normally. You are not so active, you have to be more active in the recreation. It is the reason that my country, we have so many sportsmen, sportswomen in different kinds of sports. Maybe your climatic conditions are not so proper one, but you are now a very rich country, and you can find not only to go to gymnasium, just to go in the morning for exercise. There are Chinese people everywhere in the world is practicing. It means that tourism and hospitality and culinary arts and entertainment.
It's all interrelated together,
yes,
isn't
yes.
it?
Event management, MIC, it is together under one umbrella, just integrating not only people traveling abroad. It is about 1 billion people traveling abroad. In your country, it's coming every year more than 25 million visitors. It's great industry. And people, after this, You offer me only water, and after that we shall go to take coffee somewhere. Also, it is tourism and hospitality service. It is about in your country 17% of all employment, labor force is directly or not directly included under this umbrella of tourism and hospitality industries.
So when people talk about tourism, it's beyond just, you know, going to places. Yeah. And it's
very, 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 very good definition I have to use. Beyond of even our expectation, beyond of our today perception that is tourism is just go and go somewhere and come back. It is completely time, organization, and content, and pleasure of leisure time. Mm. Leisure, it is industry of leisure time. Mm-hmm. Free choice is great.
Mm-hmm. I like the word when you say industry of leisure and pleasure, because when people think about pleasure and leisure, they don't necessarily relate it with industry.
You know, biological obligation is to sleep and to eat. Biological. Mm-hmm. Economical obligation is to work. Mm. We started this morning, 6:30, to prepare for this interview. And after that, it will be our free time. It means that everyone in your country, in our world, should realize how tourism and hospitality and culinary art, entertainment, recreation, event management, everything is our free choice.
What are the misconceptions people have about tourism, and maybe not just like ordinary people, like maybe policymakers and government and people who are involved?
I have one great honor. Maybe it is now under preparation that Ministry of Tourism Malaysia and Tourism Malaysia, your national promotion institution and your government institution, maybe we shall have one talk just as dialogue between friends. What is tourism service today? How to improve tourism in Malaysia? And we discussed just yesterday that we have few preconditions to have better tourism and hospitality industry here. It's starting from your way, from your sister, brother, young gentleman here, is starting just to educate people, young generation, to recognize that tourism and hospitality profession is first choice. It is not easy way, lazy way. By the way, it is just real choice, as Help University is using slogan, we are first choice. Yes, for the education. And inside this, you have to find that tourism and hospitality is a great challenge for young generation. Secondly, that all stakeholders, all participants should perform on harmonized way, not just one has one policy, another one there, should be together and just integrating with synergy concept that all actors of tourism and hospitality, from restaurant, hotel, just ordinary people offering us, now we are going to take coffee after this. It is second, firstly, to be educated for employees. Secondly, to organize industry to be harmonized. And third one is the most important, you already mentioned, it is awareness of society. Malaysia, truly Asia, Malaysia boleh. Malaysian people should recognize the importance how tourism is leading service industry in the world. Mm-hmm. And for your country, how important it is. Today you are a very rich country regarding your natural resources, now concentrated only to oil and gas. Mm-hmm. And tomorrow, after peak of oil is going, and you have to think what are real advantages. It is your beautiful, hospitable people. And secondly, it is your beautiful scenery, your beautiful country. And you have to use these resources given to you by God. Mm. You have to use.
What is your comment on our government's move to start the Visit Malaysia 2014?
It is just...
Oh, are you even part of this?
No, my dear. I think that I don't like only campaign. Should be permanently focused effort. Please come visit Malaysia. We are second nicest country in the world.
So it should
Croatia.
Be
yes.
Visit Malaysia all the time, not just in 2014.
I don't like campaign. I don't like to celebrating maybe International Women's Day and to express love only once. If you have love, it is permanent, should be permanent as our life. During our living time, we have to. I'm against any one kind of campaign. Maybe promotional visit, okay, but permanently, Malaysia should open door with smile and readiness to serve on the best day.
When you say permanent, I think what you meant also, it must be a form of a culture thing, like a culture
Bro.
To Bro. Accept, you know.
Bro, you, what is the reason that you are going, you like to go to London? For London, it is normally banking industry, but after that, it is service industry. Or I am not so sure, maybe they are in the same level. What is power of London today? How many foreign visitors? What is power of my country? We are a very rich country, receiving every year more than 10 million real foreign visitors, tourists. And can you imagine population of my country, just like Singapore, 4 million population. We are receiving three times more tourists than we are there. Can you imagine for your country to have 75 or maybe 100 million? In near future, it will be. Can you imagine how it is great challenge and your particular society? I believe that government is just exposition of this, but society, ordinary people, you in media, you have to inform people, not to read my book, but to think how tourism is great. You are going to Maldives, 99% or maybe 100% of Maldives GDP is just tourism and very, very little, it is fishery. Without two activities, what is Maldives? Nothing. Different countries. We are going also today to Singapore or Macau or Hong Kong or Penang or Malacca, beautiful two sites included UNESCO list of World Heritage, or go to Langkawi. It is for people there. Tourism is just should be, how to say, destiny. To think about tourism and hospitality is our destiny and our pleasure to serve people, making indeed leisure time pleasure time.
Mm-hmm. What are the different tourists or tourist categories that you can sort of explain to us? Because I know they are, you know, the rich jet setter, and they are also the backpackers. Yeah. And
but tourism is everything. Tourism is industry of free time.
Mm-hmm.
It's just one industry to offer you opportunities to discover new places there. Oh, somebody is calling, maybe tourist or somebody from tourist industry. Oh my God! It means that the tourism means all activities. What you now you are just, by the way, very charming lady. And after your work here, you will go maybe today or maybe next weekend. And all kind of services for business travelers, rich people, for family travelers, traveling for health, additional service, or be backpackers just going to Malacca or somewhere. Everything is tourism, adventure tourism, sport tourism, all activities. We have so many. For me, I'm from Mediterranean, just for we call wine road, to go from the vineyards to the vineyards to probe, to test wine, and different hunting and safari, everything. It is just, remember, my dear, it is just creative industry of your free time, and don't sleep at home more than 8 hours. Don't work more than, maybe in your case, 10 hours. And after that, enjoy life. Mm-hmm. Discover not only nature, discover different culture. And next time you have to know where is Croatia, please.
Mm-hmm. So just curious, what is your philosophy in life if you are, you know, all into pleasure and leisure and, you know, the art of just enjoying life?
No. It is hedonism if you are oriented only for pleasure. You have to work. You have to be creative. In my case, always I'm saying that tourism and hospitality is third part of our life. Because now last maybe 10 years, my tourism and hospitality is not only my free time life, is also my working obligation. Sometimes also when I'm sleeping, I'm dreaming tourism. It means 100%. What is my philosophy? Tourism means recognize different part, different side, even of your neighborhood, and just try to accept people who is serving you as just same as you are. Mm-hmm. And for my students, very often I'm saying them, please try, if you are using this profession as your first choice, you have to work with love, respecting your customers, loving them. And also you have to remember that if you are not happy, it is impossible that your customer, your guest, will be happy. Happiness is one mutual impacted. It is mutual direction. It's mutual feeling. It's very important. You can see after this dialogue, we shall go to restaurant downstairs to take a coffee. If waiter or bartender is not so happy, how to enjoy coffee? Because it is more social impact.
That's true. Yes. You know, especially a lot of complaints, you know, when it comes to customers is the service that is being provided, yes. Customer service. A lot of times, what differentiate between, you know, a restaurant that is, you know, has a lot of people and a restaurant that has no people is sometimes it's not necessarily the quality of the food, it's mostly the people. Like,
bravo,
people.
Bravo. I discussed a few days ago, one my lovely friend here invited me for the dinner, and he told me, sorry, professor, we are here mostly eating. You in Europe, you are mostly dining. It is very different. Mm. We are not animal only to feed us. Mm-hmm. Feeding somebody, it is biological needs. But we are society. We are people. I never took any breakfast, lunch along. I don't like to be. Always it is one social interaction. And normal relation between service provider and service user. Dining, remember, not only eating, dining. Mm-hmm.
Enjoying the experience.
Yes, normally. Mm-hmm. Talk to people, not to buy, use only internet or I don't know, so many devices.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about Malaysia. Because how long have you been in Malaysia for now?
My God, I was diplomat here. And after
oh, you
that,
were?
Yes.
For how long?
Oh, almost 4 years, and I was teacher. I don't like to be a professor. Teacher is guru. It is great mission. It is not job. Mm-hmm. Teacher, to teach people.
And you
As
like
our
your students.
Parents were teacher for us, mm-hmm. and our teachers. It is, and I like, and Malaysia is not only you are much smarter than others, because to me, Malaysia, truly Asia.
You really great. Believe in that slogan?
Yeah. No, to me, sorry to say, I think Indonesia is also a beautiful country. I spent there. And all your Durian ASEAN, all your ASEAN countries, members of association, very, very beautiful. And mm-hmm. European people likes your eternal summer here. Mm-hmm. It is very, not only nature. We in Europe, we are already losing smile. You are still smiling, people. And try to keep your smile. As I say always to my students, keep your smile. I think it is your advantage number one. And for Malaysia, it is beautiful combination and beautiful cocktail of mixing different cultures, different background of people, different gastronomy of people, different history, religions. It is challenge, but also you have to be very careful to keep harmonization.
Yeah, because we are a multicultural society.
Yes, it is great. It is mm-hmm. it is your advantage.
But that's the positive side. What about the side of Malaysia that you think we need to improve? You know, in not just for tourism, but you know, as an image, branding image as a whole, as a society as a whole. What kind of improvement you think Malaysians should improve, or maybe certain industry?
My dear, everyone, I look young, but I'm a very old man. And I can tell you that improvement should be permanent process. Mm-hmm. every day I am teacher, but also I'm student, studying, observing people around me, respecting others. So many things in your country should be done that you will be enough self-confident, particularly for tourism and hospitality service. It is not only hardware. It's very easy to find bank and just to build hotel or restaurant or gymnasium or entertainment place. But what about software? Who will give spiritual power there? Yesterday I gave a lecture. I'm relatively good friend of Philip Kotler, father of modern marketing, and he transformed himself, teaching on the beginning that marketing, product or service should be in the center of our interest. And after that, he realized that not only product or service, that we have to think about customer. But today, not only customer, it is must. Of people, how to recognize individual one, our spirit. It means if I can give one advice to Malaysian people, respect each other, love others, and people respect you, and people will love you and your country. Keep your smile. Smile is very important.
So in the end, it's all about the people. It's all about the software.
Absolutely, because tourist is person. You as tourist service provider, you are person. Mm. It is interpersonal relation.
A lot of the countries focus a lot on the physical side of tourism, meaning building buildings.
Yes, hardware is important. Without our hardware, it will be impossible that our listener can catch us and our conversation now. Hardware, it is just one physical precondition to have hotel. But software, people, you and me, now we are making one action.
Do you have any example of countries where you felt they really preserve the software of the country in terms of tourism?
Very, 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 very good question. I think that countries with long history in tourism and hospitality industry, like Italy, like Austria, like my Croatia, Spain, France. And tomorrow, do you know who is challenger for everything, and particularly for tourism? China. Great China. They will be, I think, number one tourist country in the world. Using great and long history legacy. Cultural legacy. And normally they are building hotels, restaurants, highways, infrastructure and everything. And it is reason that Help University has so many students coming from China. Today at 11:30 I will give a talk to Chinese student coming from one province here and just to study. And I think that they are students of tourism and hospitality management program. And to educate people for tourism and for them to be active, finding, as I have to remember many times, to accept profession as first choice. As for Maldives, for Singapore, for Hong Kong, Macau, Croatia, London, Madrid, Alaska, everywhere in the world, people is recognizing how is great challenge to invite people to be there. And even just in your area here in Petaling Jaya, how many people today will work to serve you? How many people? And it is government and society should just accept profession and very high dignity action, serving people with love and respect.
So yeah, in the end, it's all about, you know, the software, like you say, love and respect. Yeah. Okay, but let's talk about the hardware stuff for now. In terms of tourist services, when it comes to improving, you know, the physical side of it, what are the areas that you think Malaysian tourism should improvise? Because a lot of complaints, as what I observe, when, you know, it looks good on the brochure. For example, you go to certain areas in Malaysia, but when you reach there, the water is polluted or the hotels are, you know, not giving the services that you want, and, you know, certain infrastructure is not working. So will this contribute to the downfall of tourism?
Yes, my dear. Two sides of the picture. One is that Malaysia boleh, Malaysia beautiful country, fifth-ranked country in Asia, according to tourism activities, is great position to be just beside Singapore, Japan, South Korea, and Hong Kong. Can you imagine that Malaysia is situated as fifth, number five country
in
Asia? My God. But regarding hygienic conditions, sorry to tell you, 92nd in the world. It is
really?
Tragedy. Eh? Tragedy about pollution, about people should pay more attention, because we shall organize very soon, Help University will organize one seminar about tourism and security issues. Mm-hmm. Security is not tragical accidents. Mm-hmm. It's not only disaster made by man or by nature. Security is about also cleanliness, about hygienic condition.
Mm.
People should be poisoned, thousands and thousands of them. Can you imagine? And hygienic condition are more important. It is necessity for Malaysia to improve hygienic condition. God gave you everything. Beautiful country, beautiful people. And your government was very smart establishing one of the best infrastructure precondition for your country. Hardware, we are talking about this, beautiful hotels, restaurant, young people, they are entrepreneurs, and they are just starting with small business, be tomorrow very successful businessmen. But also country government, federal and local, they pay more attention for hygienic. You told me about pollution, about problem of water, about just everywhere. When I came to your studio, I take my shoe off, and normally to respect hygienic condition here. And also I like your culture here in Malaysia, to take shoe off when you are entering to the house. It's great, why not? Because we are entering to the house with
who knows what if you step on your shoes.
I think hygienic, other thing, normally education, normally coordination, so many efforts to establish tourism and hospitality industry as one harmonized action with many stakeholders are there, actors, many of them from customs service on the airport for your taxi drivers. By the way, your taxi service is so bad comparing with other Asian countries.
Can you imagine any bad experience?
No, not so. You can find that everywhere, great, and it is my way when I was diplomat, and now when I'm teacher, and discussing always with taxi drivers, they are very knowledgeable, high level of knowledge. They know everything, discussing every day, studying own customers. But one part of them, they are not proper, professionally based people, and it is problem. And I'm studying, and we have one techniques in our study process. It is classical techniques. You know, SWOT analysis, analyzing what is our plus, what is our minus, what is our internal ability to change, and what is our environment. We are not able to change directly our environment, but we have to change ourselves to accept positive and to reduce negative impact from environment. I think this service completely, from airport to your hotel, or homestay, or to go everywhere, it's important that all of them should work properly. Because in tourism and hospitality, we are, as customers, we are offering three golden values.
Mm-hmm. What is that?
Golden values is our free time. Time is gold.
Mm-hmm.
Not rubber time, as very often if you are going to a meeting. I was this morning on time here. because time is important. We haven't right to destroy your time with our just lazy way. It means first goal is time. Second goal is money. I'm giving my money. I'm working for my money. I'm giving you my second goal. And third one, the most important, it is golden dreams. I'm expecting to experience something wonderful coming to Malaysia. Nobody has right to destroy my three golden values. And can you imagine how it's simple if you are working properly and how it's difficult if you are not respecting? I told you maybe two words, love and respect. If you love, you have to respect.
Mm-hmm. So that is the underlying philosophy, love and respect. Yeah. Just want to want you to share more about...
Just read my last column, how to share. It is Leisure Travel Magazine. I'm columnist there. And I think what is here, you can find one paragraph.
Yeah.
Sharing. Just you can read sharing. What does it mean, sharing?
Okay, this is just want you to share more about the article that you've written in the magazine Leisure and Travel Holiday. So you wrote a letter to letters to Malaysia, Beauty and Challenge of Sharing Pleasure of Leisure and Travel. So I'm just going to read a paragraph.
Please. Why not?
One paragraph is about sharing. So, sharing is the password of an active approach, exchanging views, teaching, and or learning. This is the beauty of my profession as a teacher in a permanent process of communication between people who possess the knowledge and people who yearn to know more. My exclusive privilege was to enjoy the beauty of going places and meeting different people or of participating in different events, of experiencing various cultures and dining occasions all over the world, from the Japanese Emperor Palace to the Dayak Tribe Chief's Longhouse in Borneo. I think that my life experience has a value to be shared with others with a pleasurable obligation to present.
So, bravo, my dear. You are giving additional beautiful dimension of my writing.
Yeah.
Your pronunciation and your presentation is better than my writing. Thank you.
I see.
Thank you. It is human touch. Look at also gastronomy. Mm-hmm. It's about gastronomy. We have to accept just culture of social action, as I told you, dining. And also when my friend was teaching me about, one was about is not eating, should be dining. Another one, it is about anthropology. And F&B is anthropology, just connecting and introducing different culture of food and drink. And finally, you can find picture of my veranda.
Yeah.
You can jump from my veranda to the sea. Remember, Adriatic Sea is part of Mediterranean area. Beautiful, with three blues. Blue sea.
Mm-hmm.
For you can imagine in few areas you have blue sea, blue sky, and also blue mountain. Can you imagine? Three blues are there and beautiful,
Wow. Beautiful.
And practically, what is your position for this Leisure Travel Magazine, for your Durian ASEAN, the voice of discovery and sharing? Oh, my God, it is also your slogan, sharing.
Yeah,
sharing.
I like that you describe culinary as gastronomy.
Yes, gastronomy. I prefer this.
It
gastronomy,
sounds, yeah.
Yes, it's more than culinary art is just preparing. Gastronomy is completely what is related with our body and our mind.
Yeah, it's like an area, a field of its own, you know. It's not just like, you know,
eating or preparing or cooking.
Mm-hmm.
Because gastronomy, what is everything? Gastro, we have so many festival gastro. It is for our body, biological need, and our spiritual need.
Mm-hmm. In some countries, even the presentation of the food is important, not just, you know, the taste.
Normally. it is indeed one. And young people, it is reason that they are finding just this challenge. HELP University has one special program for tourism management, my program and hospitality management, but also they have in HELP CAT, it is HELP CAT college, they have culinary art center.
Mm-hmm.
And can you imagine how young people is expressing own talent
really?
For art? preparing and serving art of action.
But it's the sad state of today is majority of young urban would prefer to go to fast food joints.
And it is to me. I'm always saying to my students, I'm against, because to eat should be just one pleasure and sharing and just enjoying. I'm against fast food. I'm against instant technology. I'm against because we have, but fast food, it is just answer to our fast life and our fast action and fast, but it is not healthy for us. We have, and
so
but young generation, you can find my student in many, I haven't tried to promote their McDonald's, and I have so many fast food restaurants and chains of restaurants.
I think the attitudes of the locals also has to change. We need to embrace more the beauty of local food. And
Kampung, your kampung is still undiscovered treasure of your national wealth. You have to, everywhere when you are going to Rome, eat like Roman. If you are going to any other parts of the world and you have special advantage, no one has in our world this advantage to present Chinese cuisine as practically thousand and thousand years. Indian, my God, is a little bit hot and spice for me, but my son is preferring this. And finally, your Malay. Even as I told, to go, I enjoyed with my wife. We went to Borneo. It is Katingan Regency on one river there. And I spent there the most remarkable days in my life. Going there, even drinking, they have one. It is not like sake, like last night. It is drink prepared fermentation of fruits there. And just eating on traditional way, just original, just there, it is vegetable, it is fish there from the river, it is just nature-based ingredients are there, not fast food. And I think that just to conclude, what is Malaysian advantage, just combine different culture, different gastronomy as great legacy to offer people. Please come here and to discover how our ordinary people is in kampung style, why not?
So there's a lot more to food than just, you know, fast food, I guess.
Definitely.
Share with us more about Croatia. Like, what is the tourism industry in Croatia right now?
Your question was very good. Firstly, what is industry? Tourism is industry there. And within tourism, we have 1,200 islands. We are relatively large area, 60,000 square kilometers, connecting Mediterranean with middle European region. River Danube is there, River Sava, many lakes. And we have very famous listed in UNESCO World Heritage. It is Plitvice Lakes, one system of 17 or 18 lakes, so many, how to say it, is one beautiful collection of nature and cultural heritage. About 10 sites are including in UNESCO list of World Cultural of Natural Heritage. Dubrovnik is one very world famous city. Split, Trogir, Šibenik. It's very difficult for you to pronounce. It is one culture, 5,000 years long culture, and monuments are there from Roman time. It is just concluding with Renaissance and Baroque, Gothic. It is just collection of all cultural influences there. Croatia was so hospitable to accept different influence. Even today, Chinese are there, and we have so many Chinese restaurants in Croatia. Why not?
Oh, you do have Chinese restaurants.
Yes, many of them in our capital, in our Adriatic Sea coast, and practically so many tourists are coming to Croatia from different countries, normally mostly from our neighborhood country, from Germany, from Slavic country like Czech and Slovak, like also Hungarian, Austrian, traditionally one, Switzerland, France, and so it is just one, how to say, I'm always saying that Adriatic Sea, it is the shortest way to Europe, to heart of Europe, that when Europe is accessing to the sea, it is reason that we have very, very, very successful concept of tourism, combining our beauties. As I came here to this studio this morning, I gave you one small nice souvenir representing Croatia, but Croatia with one old traditional boat. Because do you know that Marco Polo was Croatian?
Oh,
he was born, yes, in one, and people is so surprised. In this time, it was Venice. Under Venice, everything was Adriatic Sea completely. But he was born in one Korčula island, maybe 50 nautical miles from my hometown. And he traveled, he was explorer. He connected different parts of the world. And using in this time only power of wind, for his ship going there. And today, normally, it's transportation revolution. You can travel everywhere. Information revolution. You can inform people, as we are this morning trying to motivate people to think how tourism is great challenge. Challenge and beauty is my, what is beauty and challenge?
Yeah,
sharing.
Beauty and challenge. What about other forms of, I would say, So what about transportation? How important it is accelerating the tourism industry? I mean, I don't think there will be a thriving tourism industry without the aviation industry, without a good public transportation, without good interconnected roads and all that. So what is your take on that?
My dear, as I told you before, three golden values: time, money, dreams. But we have also two additional fingers in our hand. It is, next one, it is accessibility. Accessibility. If you have three previously explained values, if you are not able to go to, for example, Nepal, Tibet, Langkawi, Malak, and last one, or maybe first one, is information. It means information revolution, a revolution of transport. But normally you can go with your bicycle, but it means moving to, for long distance, normally aviation. And who knows, tomorrow it will be one special, maybe space tourism, who knows how it will be, always invention in modern time, how to be more movable. And I think for your Malaysia, you have good highways.
Bad taxis.
No, my dear. And also you can find wonderful, wonderful taxi drivers. It was just, we discussed this morning about bad side, but everywhere you can find better side. My way to survive in my life was always choosing and accepting better side. People was asking, Angelko, what is the reason that you are always happy? Because it is my choice. You have many reasons, even now, to think about bad things, but I'm thinking and accepting only better side of life, knowing that also exists bad, but choose. And my suggestion to you and your listener, try to discover better side of your life.
So any last comments on
just this. Please be able to recognize and to catch better side of your life. Be happy and making people around you happy too,
and have lots of good food.
Yes, why not?
Gastronomy. That's a new word that I think we should really embrace instead of eating fast food.
And love people, respect people. Ah, love. So many messages. I don't know what is the most important.
I think
just cocktail, everything.
Yeah, cocktail, everything. I think probably love would be like the central of everything. Anyway, thank you very much. It's such a pleasure talking to you today.
Pleasure is mine. Indeed. Yeah. Thank you, charming lady. Thank you.
Thank you.